corner. And I was thinking today how great it is that we get together tonight. And we have a lot of little lights. And thinking about this season of the year, you know, we are now in the darkest days of the year. These are the shortest days, less sunshine than any other time of the year. You're probably starving for vitamin D. Your serotonin levels are really low. I'm like a motivational speaker. No, but you know what I love about being a Jesus follower and being surrounded by people who love Jesus is when things are the darkest, you just got to look real closely because there's a light there. Because that's where Jesus meets us in the most powerful ways. And so I just want to say this as just as a way to start tonight, this awesome worship. You know, if you're here tonight and you got a little place of darkness in your life, and I'm looking at it, it looks like all humans. So I'm guessing everyone here's got a little area where it's just hard and dark right now. I just hope you can bring that to Jesus tonight and just see that's what this is all about. That's where the light comes, because the darkness has no chance against the light of Jesus. So that's what we do. You know, at the counseling center a couple years ago, I got a call. And I return my calls at the end of the day. And on this particular day, I'm calling a priest who doesn't live anywhere near here. And usually priests want to tell me about a family they're working with and they're trying to dump on a counselor. And by that, I mean they're trying to refer the family to us, because that's what we do. Did I say dump? And so I thought that's what's going to happen. I said, hey, Father, so what are you into today? Kind of thing, like thinking he was going to talk about the family. And he said, well, I just heard from my confessor that if I don't talk to somebody, I'm going to lose my ministry. And, you know, it's always a mixed bag when I'm people's penance. You know, they go to confession and they're like, now you need to go see Tim. It's a little confusing when people come in. It's like, I mean, you know, under other circumstances, you'd probably like me. But anyway, I say that. I don't mean to joke about that. But the point is, pastors and priests have serious things in their life. And we see a lot of pastors and a lot of priests. We see a lot of people who devoted their whole life to serving Jesus. They don't make much money, they don't have much money, and they can't afford a lot of the counseling that they'd otherwise have to go to. And they also can't find places that have a real spiritual force. So we, this year, our work with priests and pastors increased by more than 20%. We also do a lot of work with people who are under-resourced, people who really have no place to go. So when some families are facing divorce or other crises, they really just can't take out their insurance card and go get a good therapist. What they have is never going to help their counseling. Most funded, you know, state-funded places don't even provide marriage counseling. And so we get to help these people, and as long as they're motivated, we don't turn anybody away. Because we do stuff like this, and generous people give us money, so we never have to say no. So I want to thank you. I look around, I see a lot of people who've been supporting us for a lot of years. Thank you for that. One last thing I want to say, and then we're going to get on with the concert, and that is that one of the cool things about tonight is you look around and you see just a whole bunch of people who love Jesus. And we got a bunch of Catholics in the room. We got a bunch of evangelicals in the room. Our counseling center, we got a bunch of Catholic counselors, a bunch of evangelical counselors. We just love working together for the sake of Jesus so we don't get caught up in this mess. So,
guys, we've got a... No, you guys can stay up here. Don't run away. Guys, don't run. Don't run. We just, we got a couple gifts for you, some checks for $2,500 each to support your ministry.
So we just want to say thanks.
Okay, so we've got another church here tonight. St. Paul, where you at?